hey, this stuff is toxic. Toxic stuff. And, you know, you really don't need much. And the industry, the chemical industry, is big bucks, big money, and they're working hand in hand together with pharmaceutical industries. It's about eugenics. It's about creating a sick population. It's about creating not only a sick population, but a population of people that are increasingly unable to think, unable to perceive. And, of course, we could explode this into so many other dimensions of what toxins are there. Fluoride in toothpaste, sodium fluoride in the water. And, you know, if you look at a pack of rat poison, any, pick your own favorite rat poison. Of course, I don't use rat poison, but if you were to go and look at rat poison, you'll see that the only active ingredient in there is sodium fluoride, along with whatever the bait is that makes it somewhat appealing to the rat. So getting all fluoride out of your diet is a good idea, and eliminating plastics. You know, it's ludicrous to put water in place. It's ludicrous to put oil in plastic. Anything, just use glass. Glass is the best ceramic. It's the most inert, and it just has a better vibrational connection with whatever it is holding. Plastic is an evil, and so are the ingredients, of course, in our foods, the genetically modified organisms. If you're eating meat, or you're eating milk, drinking milk, or consuming milk products, you know, what are you supporting when you pay for or otherwise consume these animal derived products? What is the quality of life of the animal, and what's being injected into that animal? And you know, I think if you turn a blind eye and you just are just following what is, because that's what your parents did. You know what? I grew up, we had meat twice a day, sometimes three times a day, you know, and that's just the way it was, especially here in good old fashioned Pennsylvania Dutch land, in Pennsylvania. And you can see the shape of the people here reflects their diet. A lot of meat and potatoes, you know, and dairy, and of course high cholesterol. And you know, if you're eating meat, hey, that's your choice. But I've got news for you. We are not designed to be carnivores. We're not even really designed to be omnivores that include the eating of meat so much. Our digestive tracts are six times or more longer than those proportionately of carnivorous species. And, of course, we don't have the teeth like you would find on a dog or a cat. And so those are clear evident signs that, you know, we're not meant to eat meat, first of all. And second of all, the meat and the milk products that are being produced are of an ecosystem that's been engineered and is highly toxic to the animal and to the human organism. Including the genetically modified corn, genetically modified animals, the steroids that are being given to these animals to make them grow exorbitantly over very short periods of time, to be grotesquely overweight, so much so they can't stand under their own weight, the abuse that these animals have to suffer. And of course, the the antibiotic regimens that are administered to keep them from getting sick from the unnatural diet of soy and corn and whatever else is in their food. And, you know, I got news for you folks. This isn't like something that is isolated and happens here or there. This is everywhere. And even those products that are listed as organic, you might have the absence of bovine growth hormone or antibiotics. But anything that's really labeled as organic, depending on its degree of certification, and USDA is probably the least stringent and the most susceptible to creeping corruption of what's allowable. But they do make provision for organic. They do make provision for pesticide treatments of say different plants and fruit, vegetables, and animals as well. Medicinal treatments. So just that it's labeled organic doesn't even necessarily mean that it's free of chemicals. So really the best bet for you and your loved ones, your family, is to increasingly go raw, local, homegrown, where you know who is growing your food. And they don't need any certification as long as they're using natural composting and increasingly biodynamic species diversity, where they're growing food not in a monoculturistic kind of mindset, but rather that they're embracing the richness of interaction of plants and of course pollinating species. And you're going to have a much better, healthier food, tastier food. And when you eat these fruits and vegetables and grains, nuts, seeds, when you eat those raw, you're getting the vital life force of these foods. Whereas when you cook them, you're destroying the perfect balance of proteins and enzymes of the food. So going raw is definitely going raw and organic, if not homegrown, or a combination of those, and increasingly vegetarian is a way that you can really improve your health. So eliminating toxins, chemical toxins, and the big one is electromagnetic fields. And electromagnetic fields come from so many different devices and sources in our environment every single day. And to think 70 years ago that electricity wasn't really even common in the developed world, in the household of the average household. And now today, of course, we have the wonder of the internet and the amazing communicative possibilities that it brings. We also are being presented with the danger of not only the possibility, but the real danger that these electromagnetic fields are having an effect on our biochemistry, because we're made up of trillions of cells, and those cells' lives are not necessarily genetically predestined, but are instead much a product of their environment. I'm reading this great book here. It's by Bruce Lipton. It's called Biology of Belief: Unleashing the Power of Consciousness, Matter, and Miracles. And Bruce Lipton goes on to explain how much we are products of our environment, how the cell itself, its brain is not the nucleus. It's not predestined to live out its genetic predisposition, but rather that the cell membrane and its bio its phospholipid structure. It's in other words, it's the membrane is the brain, and is also partly the memory of the cell's experience, and it's the experience that the cell has with its environment that reveals parts of its genetic operation. And so cell is really a product of its environment. And of course, we are a collection of cells, and therefore things that happen in our environment, and including our own mental, emotional state, has a great effect on the outcome of our health, the sustenance of our health. This has been quite a road for me to travel, because in 2008, I was diagnosed with multiple myeloma. And I am one who has rarely ever had to go to the doctor, with rare exception of maybe, you know, having a broken bone or something. But increasingly, I was unable to really walk. I was chronically fatigued. I felt like I had kidney stones with excruciating pains in my sides, and I landed in the hospital, and I already had the suspicion of what it was that was the cause of my ailment, and my friends brought my laptop in, and I did a search on cancer and hybrid car, and sure enough, the second or third listing in the search results was a New York Times article on the suspicion of the dangers of electromagnetic fields present in hybrid vehicles and the possibility that leukemic type disorders would arise from this. And of course, it's long been known and associated that people living near high voltage power transmission lines have lymphomas and leukemias, and especially children. And of course, now we're seeing that leukemias has been displaced as the number one childhood cancer by a brain tumor on the right side of the head, where you know, tiny preteens are already glued to a cell phone a good number of hours a day. But you know, the younger you are, the more rapid the cells are dividing and multiplying, because you're growing. And so, of course, younger people are increasingly susceptible to leukemic disorders. However, I've been driving this Toyota Prius since 2002, and there was always something very etheric and mysterious feeling about that car. But, yeah, wow. I'd become really tired. I'd get in the car, I'd turn the key, and I'd be, oh, God, something is sucking it out of me.